Hello and welcome to Badger Cam RC. In this new build video, I'm going to be having a go at making the Morston semi-scale Norfolk Crab Boat. It's made by Hughes Aircraft Kits, and apparently it's easy build, so it should be perfect for me considering the amount of mess ups I've made on my last two boat builds. Everything seems pretty straightforward with the kit. Got some nice laser cut parts, so no worrying about if things are the right shape. This main piece here is for all the structurally important bits, nice bit of thicker plywood. Then under that you've got some thinner plywood for all the side pieces, and some medium plywood for all of the decks and the cabin walls and things like that. The kit also comes with a little bag of goodies to put in the boathouse when the time comes, and some plastic window frames and window templates, along with a sheet of plastic to put them on, if I can get it off that piece of tape, to complete the kit. The only thing the kit doesn't come with is the RC gear, and as you can see a few of you off in the background of the video, I've already bought a few bits so I can crack on with this kit. Now, before we start, let's have a look at the instructions. That's what I like to see. Nice, simple, obvious, no room for vague interpretations. Use a square to make the form. Make sure the form is a vertical. The square is on standby. A Sandvik, possibly late Iron Age. Everything seems very simple and very straightforward. And having read that, I'm quite looking forward to this kit now. So yeah, without further ado, let's get on with the Morston Crab Boat kit. Now the first thing to do is get this lower deck out of the frame. Now you could probably get away with popping this out, but I don't want to chance it, as I know what wood can be like. It can be temperamental and like to crack. So let's give it a quick score with the X-Acto knife. Work your way around through all these little tabs. There's only six of them. Get them through, and then there we go. Simple enough. Now, until this is called for, move that out of the way. I'm going to do the same thing for this piece here, B2. So, see if we can have the same success as we did with the last one. Go around all the tabs. Oh, they are a little bit hard to get through with this. I think I should get some of a handle. Score around, and then just there we go. A little bit of a score just eliminates a bit more of that risk of cracking. So, same again, only a couple of tabs on each piece, thankfully. There we go, nice and simple. Now, with that cut out, simply a matter of gluing B2. In place. Seems a good fit. There's no room for it to wiggle left or right much, so should be a nice exact bit of a placement. We're going to get the square, make sure it's in square, and we line it up against that. Pin it down a little bit, double check before the glue goes in, because once the glue goes in, if you've done it wrong, you're in trouble. Says to only use cyno, so we're using cyno, and run a little bead along there. Now I'm just going to let that glue do its work and move on to the next step, but I think I'm going to cut them pieces out, because you've already seen two. You don't want a whole video of just me chipping away at the corners of tabs, so let's speed things up a bit. Now with B2 nicely glued in place, it's time to fit B3. Simply goes in there, and the two deck side pieces. So deck side should go in there like that, and should go in there like that. Yeah, that's nice and easy, does it? Gonna have to double check I haven't put one of them on backwards, as One seems to fit better than the other. Have I done anything weird? Deck side and deck side. Am I doing something weird? Is there meant to be a gap? Sorry about this, folks. Stubs back, B3 in haul position, that's B3. Inner haul sides, have I got the wrong part? Surely not, there's nothing else that looks like that. Well, this is the build process, so let's see, it's not on that one. Definitely not on that one. Definitely not on that one either. This is odd. There's no other slots that could possibly go into. There's a little tab there, that could be doing it. If in doubt, check the parts I cleaned. I might be causing myself that minor abbreviation. And there's still a gap. Why is there a gap on one side and not the other? Let's just go around another way. Is there a slight thing to it? No, there's some, it's definitely symmetrical. Look at that. Okay, now you're level. You're still over the back? Well, I'm two steps in and I'm already scratching my head. It was supposed to be an easy kit. It was supposed to be an easy kit. Oh. Is there some sort of trick I'm missing? Have I put them? Will they go in backwards? They definitely won't go in backwards. So yeah, got a bit of head scratching later. Put the two pieces on top of each other. And yeah. G is the good piece, the bad piece underneath is shunted 2 millimeters forward and won't fit in without a little bit of modification. Off camera, I have slashed my finger open trying to do this, so my blood offering for this project is complete. So, God's be praised, this should be a good build now. It's had about a quart of blood played all over the place. So, yeah, I'm going to get the Dremel. Dremel back these corners here after marking them, and then the build should be able to progress as normal. I'm not too happy about that though. I may have to phone up you and say, "Oi you," in the nicest possible way. You're 2 mils out on one of your deck sides. A little bit of a kit bashing later. Will it go in? Yes, there we go. See, it's easy when the parts fit. Please, kit, no more of that. How much blood I've got left. Right, so I'm going to get the set square, prop these up, do some heavy on this side. Heavy, heavy, heavy old tub of resin. There we go, that'll do. So prop that one up there. I think that's not how a square works. Prop that side up there. Click it in. And time to go around with the super glue. Should have poured some super glue in my cut actually. It was made for that originally, before us modelers got hold of it. Bit of glue in these parts. Right then. And that was a breath of fresh air. Nice and relaxing. Ooh, zen. Anyway, while I'm trying to regrow a few red blood cells, I'm going to leave that to dry. Some drying later. That's all in place now. Now what to do, turn it over and it's time to fit the keel pieces. Now I'm going to RC mine, and I've already seen a little thing that you might want to get sorted now. If you're going to RC it, then leave till later. This little bit here, that's where the prop shaft's going to go along, and with the square for the tab intact, yeah, there's no way you're sliding a prop shaft into that. I've double checked it against the prop shaft, so what I've done is I've just trimmed down this forward tab on the front part of the keel, and with that sorted, fitting the prop shaft should be a breeze. So I simply slide down into there, and then we've got the back one to go in. Simply come, slide it and click it into there, and then glue them into place. Now I'm going to just glue them in and get on with the next bit. Now the next bit is to glue this piece in here, B4, and I trial fitted it before I showed you guys, and it picked up a little bit of glue off the keel piece, and yeah, it's in there permanently now. Now the next bit to do is add this piece, B1, and that's going to go up in the front around there. So there we go, like that. That piece in place, little bead of super glue. Top to run down and be safe. There we go. It's coming together quite easily. A little bit of that problem at the start, but now that's behind us, it's flying together. This video's probably about 10-15 minutes long at the moment. It's probably taking me about 45 minutes to get to this stage, but I'm not rushing. I've had a couple of cups of coffee along the way, so my hands are shaking. And yeah, on to the next step. I think we're doing the transom next, so we're down at the end of the shift for the change. Now, what we're going to fit is the two transom supports. Easy peasy. One in there, and another one in there. Oh, I've put them on upside down, so turn it round. Turn it round. And then once we've got that, fit the transom to that. Now, I will say, one thing that's nice about this kit, every part is labelled up. So if you take them all out of the sheets in one go, you can do, and just leave them all stacked up. You're not going to miss a part or get another part confused with something it's not meant to be. And I think that's definitely a big plus for this kit. Nice feature. Kind of difficult to do this working around a camera. I think I need to work on my setup, as it's what's been causing me to not show much of the actual making in the last few videos. This is good, but it's not as good as it could be. Pin that in there, bit of glue, and that should be it. It is a simple kit. That tiny little bit earlier has blackened what is actually one of the easiest kits I've built so far. I know there's a few issues with the hull later on. Sure, that's going to be fun. Hulls are always interesting to try and glue around things. But so far, the inner framework, it's good. It's solid. It's not rattling. Yeah. I'm looking forward to seeing how this comes together as a boat. I'm going to try and make it one of those charter fishing boats that you go on as a kid out for a day trip. Either that, or I might make it into a fully working lobster boat. Put all the lobster pots and crates on the back. That might be fun to build. With this video, I'm not releasing it all after I've built it though. So let me know in the comments down below what you think it should be, charter boat or lobster boat, and aim to finish it in whichever one you chaps choose. So put your votes in now. Anyway, moving on. Now it's asking me to fit the deck halves in, or lower deck halves. And, everything's fitted in nicely. A little bit of a squeeze around these points, but that's good. With the glue, it's going to be really rock solid. You need to kind of hold it down at the back as this is gluing to get that curvature. I'm gluing the back in, and then I'm going to glue the front in afterwards. And a bit of my blood there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do some of this off camera, as it's simply a case of glue and hold it in. It seems to work best if you go from the back off. I've glued this side in. But if you glue from the back and make sure it lines up with that, it seems to follow suit up here at the front end. Just try and get, if we can get the camera around, these two pieces to meet halfway in the middle. But yeah, nothing too complicated there.
Now with the lower deck portions fitted, I've gone away and I've added a couple of keel supports to the underside of the ship. And I think for this episode, I'm going to call it there, as I'm going to have to do a few little bits and pieces to make this suitable for RC. And I don't want to press too far ahead and make things harder on myself. I know for a fact I'm going to have to drill a bunch of holes in these to allow for some wires to go down the side between the servo and the ESC, which is going to have to be in the front, as it's the only place there's room for it. I'm also going to have to drill a few little bits and pieces down here and possibly find a bit of wood to fit to the lower deck to attach the motor to it. And I also get the feeling that it'll be better to drill a hole in there and fit the rudder while these sides are off, rather than trying to fit everything through that tiny little opening. But all in all, other than a little bit of a stumble straight out of the starting gates, step two being 2 millimeters too far forward, it is a really easy build kit. It's quite nice and solid as well. There's nothing rocking all over the place. Once you've got the initial pieces in with a square, everything else just follows suit, really. So yeah, definitely living up to its name as an easy built kit. And from the bits that are exposed on the top, I think when it's done, this is going to be quite a nice little fishing launch. Anyway, that's all for this week's episode. As always, thank you for watching. And if you're building one of these at home, I hope you've found the video helpful and gives you a bit of an idea of what to expect. If you're not building one at home, well, I hope you've just enjoyed me fumbling my way through another build project. Until next time, look after yourselves and have a good one. Goodbye.